to pass the act and preached by Brother Agbilia Akani at the Holy Convocation held in Kaduna on 28 October 1999. For further inquiries, please contact Place of Refuge, P.O. Box 7332, Kaduna, Nigeria. Telephone 062-211-697 or 062-235-471. God bless you as you listen.
You may be seated for 15 minutes before we stand up again. I'd like to, and tonight we are going to go on to start looking at preparing, personal preparation for revival. But I would like us to take our hymn sheets and we make a prayer to God. We take hymn 1 as our prayer song for tonight. Pass me not, O gentle Savior, you are my only guide. I want you to note the issues. When it is time for God to visit a man, the Lord was speaking to us yesterday that we need to recognize the time of our visitation. When it is time for God to visit a man, or to pass through a land, or to pass through a congregation, it is possible that revival will come and you will be unaware. That's why we are going to be singing that song. It is possible that God will have come to do a miracle while you are still thinking it is yet to come. And it is terrible to keep expecting when the man you are looking for has come and gone. We are in a very crucial hour, in a crucial time when God is winding up his program. And one of the critical programs that God needs to bring before the final winding up of the dispensation of grace is what we realize in the Word of God as the midnight cry. Do you remember the 10 virgins that were all waiting for the Lord Jesus? Do you remember them? Now, do you remember the Bible says they all slept? Do you remember they all slept? The 10 of them slept. There was a period, and that is quite prophetic. They started with zeal. They started with great expectation. They all went out as virgins to wait for their Lord. Now I want you to know that the church started out in zeal, started with great expectation. The church actually was born in revival. If there was no revival at the time of Pentecost, there would be no church today. Especially with the terrible persecution that came on them, with the way they were beaten and dragged on the floor, with the way many things happened to them, there would not have been anything left today. But because they started off in revival, they started off with zeal. Can you imagine the Bible says, in one day 3,000 were baptized, and those 3,000, they stood in the apostles' doctrine. Day and night, they were breaking their bread and going from house to house. And with great grace, the apostles gave a witness about the resurrection. And many were saved, many were affected, many miracles, notable works, wonders, and signs were wrought by the hand of the apostles. Hallelujah. And you remember that that wave of revival continued until Acts chapter 6. when he looks as if the leaders of that particular revival were beginning to sleep. They were beginning to enter into administration. And God sent another way unto them. That way that came was more of a serious persecution. And that persecution was so much that they were scattered from Jerusalem. The persecutors, their mind was to stop the way. You remember that? They planned that anybody that will speak about this way must be punished with death. And they thought it was Stephen, because by this time Stephen had become very, very notable among the men that God was using to spearhead the revival. I'm telling you a story because we are going to pray before we can take our charge and before we can disperse tonight. Whenever God wants to send revival, he needs to raise men. Are you understanding? The devil also knows that men, correct men, revived men, is also the key to revival. So whensoever he also wants to kill a revival, it was this man he seeks to kill. Sometimes it is not by killing them physically. It is by killing their zeal. It is by killing their vision. It is by killing their understanding. It is by killing their consecration. It is by threatening them. It threatens them several times. And once men that bore the crown of their anointing over their heads begin to graduate, you can imagine what happens to the rest. But you see, God needed another waking up so that that revival will not die in chapter 6. And the Lord did a miracle. But Stephen had to die. And from the death of Stephen, a new wave of revival broke out again, spearheaded by some other people that will not even know their names. They went everywhere preaching the gospel. Hallelujah. And that revival was also beginning to settle by the time we came to chapter 11 and chapter 12. And God needed to raise that fire on. And earlier on in chapter 9, he had gone and arrested Paul, whom he was saying that, "I have arrested you, I have apprehended you, because there is something you will do for me in this generation." So you know, it takes God to get correct men to use in order to spearhead revivals. It is unfortunate that most times you don't get those men in a row. Sometimes a man will arise, and after him, maybe for another 40 years, there's no other man. And God has to keep searching. Praise the Lord. But you see, usually, the work of God started in the revival, in a great outpouring of the Holy Spirit. But we also realize that there comes a time when all the virgins flop. When we talk of flipping, we are talking about becoming unconscious. What you are holding before you sleep, it will suddenly fall out. So when you are having the rest is now, it will just fall out of your hand. A sign of flip is when those things you are holding before begin to fall out. When issues that you are very paramount to your life begin to slip out of your hand. And the Bible says, they all fled. And I would like to say to you, dear brothers, that it does not matter how many years ago you are fled. That is not the issue now. It does not matter how many years ago you have been oblivious unto the purpose of God for your life and for your family and for your generation. That is not the case now. And I do think Jesus rejected the five virgins because they slept. If it was because they slept, nobody will have gone in the field. Do you remember that? So it was not a group that God was particular about, but that shortly before the master came, there was a midnight cry that woke up everybody. And I'm telling you, dear brothers and sisters, that the time of the midnight cry has arrived. What we are going through now, and I want you to know that it is not only happening in this area, it is happening all over the country. It is happening in several nations. It is happening all over the world. There is a general outcry. It's like a midnight cry, waking up the sleeping giants. There are so many things that have fallen out of our hands as God's church while men slept. Because while men slept, the Bible says the enemy came in. And what did he do? He sowed tears. Tears of false doctrine. Tears of wrong emphasis. Tears of false and selfish gospel that have been preached. Tears of personal vanity that have dominated our pulpits. Tears that have dominated the souls of men. That you cannot easily see the resemblance of a believer with the Christ Jesus who they proclaim to want to serve. All this happened while men slept. You only do it while you sleep. But I'm telling you the answer. It is not the years. It is not the depth of sleep that is the matter as at today. The matter as at today is that the time for the midnight cry has come. The time to awake has come. The time to awake and prepare to appear before the Son of Man has come. And this is the most special moment. I pray that it does not pass you by in the name of Jesus Christ. Listen to me. It does not matter. I'm a serious sinner. We have been for years. It needs to know and see when those things have been slept. Some of them are even this morning. They slept so much, some of them are even so badly. But one thing that I thank God for was that the midnight cry, the trumpet that blew, woke them up. But when they woke up, the peculiar mark in their lives was the trouble that pushed them out of the kingdom. So while we are talking about revival, I want you to know that this is God's strategic work at this point in which we stand. And you need to do your best not to miss this last chance. There are many that are first that shall be last. There are some that used to be very zealous, but this last disposition may not carry them through, and the loss will be polluted, it will be irretrievable. The loss that will be nothing to do to correct it, it will be finished. Even as we call this meeting, as we know and see the only thing, this is the time to prepare my people for my visitation. I want God to strike your heart that everything that you must do as an individual to get yourself prepared, we are talking of revival. revival. Some say that it is revival you can really talk about until you come to book of revival. Hallelujah. So there is a great cry. It may appear to the world, everything is going on. There is an awakening going on already. But let me ask you to pray with me tonight. A very deep prayer, a very personal prayer. Lord, you and others, you are touching. Don't pass me by. Don't. This is not a song you will think you are never to hear. No, it is God that must hear you. And as you begin tonight to study what is the feeling to prepare for the banner, fight as individuals, then as a family. I pray that you will be able to prepare not only yourself, but your family. Lot needed a revival. Do you remember? Just before his own world will be destroyed, he needed a revival. And God sent angels, messengers, who then have preached unto him again and forever. God is going to restore this land. Get ready and get out. Get ready and do what? And get out. Ah! And imagine when that man was unlucky. He needed to prepare himself and his family. Unfortunately, the way he had lent his family to gift, the short time he had was not enough to get them out. Remember that he made frantic effort, and I imagine the way he went about preaching that night. He had been revived to preach. And he went to the first daughter, and he phoned him and he called him and said, "The Lord has done that for me again. If I were in this condition in which I am now, when you are asking for my daughter in marriage, I will not have allowed. For I know it was a lukewarm working. Nevertheless, God is giving you a second chance. The Lord will overflow this place with honor and brimstone. Stand up and let go." The family must say, "Daddy, even if I were to consider what you are saying, the message is too short. Even if I were to just wait and wait and follow you, I am not prepared for such a sudden exit from a land I have lived in all my life." And he knew that his first daughter, as he waited, you knew your new girl is never married. You gave me to marry to this man with my own man is not going there. Where you die, I will die. When God will revive you as you are sitting here before the Lord tonight, may God also help you to bear the responsibility of preparing your immediate family for the need of the Lord. And someone has disappointed not yet to the second daughter and her own husband. They say, "Ah, Baba, what are you doing this late night?" He said, "Well, the Lord has just come. The Lord has just come to show us favor. He's going to overthrow this land, and we must get ready and get out." The other man said, "Is that why you are wearing your hat? I hope it is not a sickness that is wearing you. What do you mean by that? There's nothing like that. Don't relax. In any place, you can go anywhere you like to go. This is our own country. You're the only person that you're sojourning in. I was born there. My citizenship is here. Don't know anywhere to go then. If you're so thankful to go to help me without his children, you're so thankful. He went to Abarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarab And the time was ticking off. And I want to tell you that fast. The time is ticking off. The time of this age is about to finish. You have to reach a time in what God is going to do. And nobody can stop the time anymore. Nobody can stop the time anymore. When you come back, they don't know they are not, they have refused to come. They come. What have you done? They went inside their bedroom and said, you could not have a name. And then most of you don't know that name. Because it's not worthy. It's not worthy of a relation. The only thing you know that name is with the blood. She must have pushed blood in the body of. She was wearing the window of talking. But she pretended not to hear. Not only you must know. Your husband told you that telling you, your number one can only have such funny things. What am I doing? I'm not to help you for anything. We come back. You just are going to be grateful before them. That's why I was nodding my head. I said I was my dream. I'm not going anywhere. There are some of you that are not that far. You have not been able. You have not been able to bring your life under the control of the word of God. When you come to church, you sit down the line when you get to your own door. That is the thing. That's the reality. And I just don't want to be good to that guy. I kept quiet. But count me out of that program. Not in trust. That is why you have to develop a person. Because the view you are supposed to go with you is not on the way. You can make my cry. I want you to pray, Lord, don't pass me by. That's how Uncle Lot lost his wife. She became a pillar of salt. The two girls that we thought were seriously converted, were they converted? These were unbelievers in the house. These were girls that were only guilty. The opportunity to break out. And when they believe on them, they cannot drag them, I imagine. They can drag them. And when they break out them, whether one is used to the other one's people, they are up in a man. When are we going to go to a man to sleep with them? Instead of coming to go and say, Father, what is your purpose for our lives? For you to know that sodomy is doing something. Even though they are giving the opportunity to pass things out there, with the new side of their lives. The senior one called the junior one said, what are you doing? The junior one said, well, the only man who has our father. They started making faith to their father. They did that for some 1 or 2 or 3 weeks. Their father was not dead. How can I do that? My wife has become the pillar of God. They are my daughter. They are working promptly before their own father. If you know one called the senior and sister, this is not the work. You must get things wrong. You must have to get to my father. What do they learn that matter? Some of you are dating your children in the community here. He's the champion friends to me, the new family. The only thing that is important about is the language, the news, and the television. All those things you let them watch it, is the thing that in their hands. Of course, they come here, they come here. Whenever it's a good music, or oh, you put them down to bed, you will watch their leg. The new thing is the music of music. They know where they are going to sleep. And they see so bad, they don't tell you to stop singing. And they let's sleep. No, 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 let's go, let's go. You see, they tell you, well, that's the one you are. They want you to sleep up. They go to the house of work. And they first go around to the house. And the rest of the family are asleep. When they came out, the genius man said, the great ones of this kind is very strong, I'm coming with this family. They look at me again, they turn their ears up. And they go to the medical school. And they go down with it. And today, the enemy, the mother, that we have developed out of that, the one who has a relationship, that they are accursed. They brought confusion to the world. For you to know that Jezebel is in that country. All the gods that are sprung up in the days of Baal, they are from that country. What will both for out of your life? When you see a plan comes, when God is saying, everybody must wake up. You don't know whether these things passes on the ground or will ever come the day in your lifetime. When some people did not know their plan of dissipation, and the Lord let them get away. It is 3,000 years now. They are still better. So if you put that song in prayer, that woman owes 24 years. You are not only crying, you are an other. You are crying. Take this with all your heart.
Yeah. Corinthians chapter 3. And we are going to look at verse 16, verse 17, up to verse 20. And he said, "Thus saith the Lord, make this valley full of ditches. For thus saith the Lord, ye shall not see rain, neither shall ye see rain. Yet that valley shall be filled with water. But ye may drink both you and your cattle and your beasts. And this is but a mouth thing in the sight of the Lord. He will deliver the mother also with your hand. And we shall see every five city and every five city that shall formerly be filled and stop all wells of water. And now every good piece of land is filled. And it came to pass in the morning, when the meat offering was offered, that behold, there came water by the way of heaven, and the country was filled with water. May we stand there. May God bless the Lord our spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. There was a passage that may appear a bit strange in the matter that we are confronted with in the course of tonight and in the course of this mobilization for revival. But I perceive the Lord wants to give us personal instructions as to that how to prepare for the coming visitation. How can you prepare to be a part of the move of God that will usher in the church into the presence of the Son of Man? I don't know, but I want you to note this very strongly in your spirit, that we have entered into a corner. The beginning of our takeoff is here. And it looks as if there's going to be multiple labor. God is going to give the truth to every man, all these that have slept, to regroup what has fallen out of their hands once more. But I want you to know that when that is happening, the world system is also going to enter into their own final journey. So the matter of revival that we are talking about is going to be the divine action of God, yet in the midst of the highest level of conflict. But you need, as an individual, to hear God speak particularly to your life and get you connected with what God wants to do in our generation. And the same thing that the Lord will be saying in the course of this meeting, it will be just for primary, for personal application. And yet I know God will be speaking further to us. how to prepare for what he's about to do, even as a church. But to me, that being the Lord, wanting to do something that I call a coping for the coming revival. And the kind of thing I want God to help us do, because only when you see this tonight, you will not finish it. And when you speak of God, you will bring up His wisdom with your spirit at any point. I want to demand of you, don't wait for me to finish what I'm saying before you get on your knees, before you begin to respond to what you're saying. Is urging you to do immediately. Now, these things, the kings of Israel and the king of Judah, they came together to fight a battle. But you know that Ahab had been a very careless man, as far as serving God is concerned, and even his own son was not different. But we are going to join alliance with Jehoshaphat, because Moab has stood against Israel, and the battle was very, very serious. We are told that they have already stopped all the water crossings. That was working the land of Israel. Everywhere was now dry. And the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat, they went and approached Elijah. They were asking, what shall we do in facing this battle that has come against the people of God? Elijah was very, very unwilling to respond to their request because of sinfulness and disobedience in the life of the king of Israel over the time. But because Jehoshaphat, a God-fearing man, he was bent on hearing what God would say. Praise the Lord. Listen to me. There comes a level of backsliding the life of people that even if they come, God may not be exalted to tell them his truth. So people may gather over and over time, but they will not be talking what is the secret intention of God, because God has concluded that they are itching ears and they are not willing to hear the truth. But I believe that God still has a speech in his heart to share with us the depth of his intention. As Jehoshaphat came, Elijah prayed, if the evil for this man Jehoshaphat, I will not have answered you. I will have asked you to go and approach them to their end. The God took you by your hand and lead you into his fullness in the name of Jesus Christ. But there was an instruction that God was going to give when eventually he decided to speak. Elisha said in verse 14, said, "As the law of Israel, before whom I stand, surely, while you know that I will regard the presence of Jehovah, the king of Judah, by no means towards you, you see me. But now, bring me a minister." And it came to pass, when the minister prayed, that the hand of the Lord came upon him. I don't know whether you are going to see what I'm talking about. A situation came in the land of Israel. Especially if you know that Elisha was particularly located in that land. There are no options for the situation. A minister has to pray before an option will come to his life this time around. But what God began to say is the issue that we need to quickly deal with together and tonight the God tonight. And he said, just say the Lord, make this valley. What? Full of bushes. Yes. Make this valley.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But there is this instruction that the Holy Spirit was bringing forth unto his people, which they will need to quickly understand individually to it, and then they can do it together with the other. Make this body what? Full of duty. Yes, you may not see well, you may not see wind, you may not see everything, nothing will soak, but this valley will be filled with water. And I see a divine instruction. For the real God, you have us to labor to prepare ourselves for his visitation, even now. So let me come back and you now look at what does this mean to make this valley full of beauty. What is God talking about as far as you and yourself are concerned? If the Lord says, you may not see me. You may not see me. But bend down, and make this valley filled of bitterness. It shall be filled with water, the water that will water the whole land, the water that will feed the whole land. Men shall drink, beasts shall drink, every other man will be satisfied because your dog bit it. Praise the Lord. But I would like you to see two things before I go ahead from there. They are to give victims in a dry ground. Names are the name. And they talk a lot of big victims. It will be softer. It will be easy. But God was asking them to do what will look almost impossible in preparing for divine visitation. There are two issues there to overcome the soil and create a deep ditch in order for the Lord to fill with his divine visitation. But as I was looking at that, I quickly remembered that yes, there was another man in search of refreshing, in search of enlargement, he had himself to start digging ditches or digging what we call wells. That man was Isaac. In Genesis chapter 26, we notice certain things happened to Isaac. I would like you to look at it because we are going to study this two pictures in parallel. And then we shall draw our conclusion to pray. Praise the Lord. Now, follow me to Genesis 26. Put your hand in this chapter 3 verse 16, I will write. We only want to look at Genesis 26. You have to give us a little insight into where God will have us to begin our preparation tonight. In Genesis 26, you come in contact with Isaac living in a very strange land in Gerar. You are limited to go down to Egypt. When the Lord said, do not go down to Egypt. Therefore, they said, join this man, and I will go with you there. Even though the man was dry, God told him to join there. In verse 12, in verse 13, up to verse 14, we notice the visitation of God on the land of Isaac, but the Bible says the Lord blessed him. But the man went great, went forward, and grew until he became very great. He had possession of flocks, he had possession of herds, he had great store of servants. And the Philistines, they did what? They envied him. They envied him. And when the Philistines noticed that Isaac was growing in a proportion that they didn't like, and that is something that I would like you to know. When the Philistines noticed the growth of Isaac, that he was going to wax strong, they thought of how to stop him. Please listen. They thought of how can we stop him? How can we bring this man to stop? How can we make sure he does not progress beyond here? Should we confront him directly? Should we confront him with God? And the Philistine says, no. That will not help us. We can do something for his life. And we will approach him. So what did they decide to do? They decided to stop. All the words that his father had dug that produced water, both of him, for children and for people. They knew that wherever there is no water, no matter what you planted, it will soon die out. They also knew that where there is no water, everything will soon perish. And so they decided to attack Isaac by blocking the well that supplied him water. You see, each time we talk of revival, most of the time we will find it has to be temple of rain. Is that all right? We are always believing that revival is a shower. The shower of blessing. Every time the scripture when we talk about the Holy Spirit, it talks about the Holy Spirit as what? As the leaders of living water. Sometimes when you want to talk about the release of the word of God into the church, the word that can sanctify, you will talk about the water, the washing of water by the word, the washing of regeneration by the word of God. So in various angles, water or rain represents the outpouring of the Spirit of God, of the release of the word of God that can sanctify the church. And so when water begins to be cast, whether in the Old Testament or the New Testament, it talks about a condition of great heaven. Praise the Lord. Whenever the Lord has sinned, one of the things that God does is to close the heaven and turn the rain of their land to become what? But not even. Hallelujah. When God wanted to punish Ahab for his worthlessness, what did he do? He shook the rain that did not come down. It has always been like that. So when the children of Philistines noticed that Isaac was beginning to become very prominent, they knew where to stop him. By stopping his water. By stopping the source of water, they blocked it. Abimelech said unto Abimelech, Go from us, for thou art mightier than we. Departed. Let's go further. Many of the things that these dramas of the church, which we are going to case study as we go through the Bible study, these are wells of water. Jesus told the woman of Samaria. Do you remember what he said to the woman of Samaria? He said, the water that I shall give him shall become what? A water of living water. You know, spring up unto everlasting life. Whoever believeth in me, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. And God said, when he said this, he spoke of the Holy Spirit, that those who believe on him were to do what? To receive. Every time God wants to send a revival, it is represented in Scripture. A flow of water, a flow of rivers of living water. And whenever God wants to talk about dryness and lack of revival, he talks about clearing the heavens and making sure it does not rain or stopping the flow. But listen to me. This one, I want you to listen before we go back to Bible. God gave the document to take something to me. Hallelujah. God is asking you to dig something to me. It means to me and see what is leading to the stoppage of our revival, or the stoppage of the flow of the grace of God and of the waters of life. That is making the issue of the number a matter to cry about is because the wheels have been stopped. The Bible said, they fill them with what? With earth. Oh, how is the Holy Spirit grant us understanding quickly tonight so that we can begin to do? I want you to picture the well that is full of water. When the Philistines noticed that this is the source of life, this is the source of the power, this is the source of the progress of this man Isaac, before we will stop it. And what did they do? They carry a shovel. I want you to listen to me. There are some of you today, your wheels are completely blocked. And God said, make this body full of ditches. Dig it up. With the earth, the stuffy world, with the earth. But there are some of you, your words is not yet completely blocked because it is not the first shoulder that blocks a well. You also need to remember. You also need to dig. When you believe this, the final that you will not allow this man to progress. We are going to stop him! We are going to stop him! Now they carry a shovel. Once in a while,
baby, they carry the shovel aside. You are. That one shovel, did you stop the one? What did they do? You made the water nourish. There are some of you, the water of your life, if you actually stopped, there is nourish. Your inner man is not completely blocked. There is this magic. I imagine that Isaac may have gone near the one and said, oh, what is making this thing to look and nerdy today? He did not recognize that the Philistines were at work. To post Superman and Godman to watch that world. I said, let's be sure what is making this water that used to be fresh, very clean, to become muddy. But you know what we did? The thief fought that muddy water. It was not too muddy. It only changed color. And we could still drink it if we left it to settle down. Of the earth, that comes to stop the flow of the Spirit of God. That riches of the earth that has come to contaminate the purity of the Word of God in your life. That which does not allow the sharp, sensitive use of the Spirit to bring forth on your life without hindrance. In the Philippians, every single day, you have been blessing. And they came again with another shovel. Don't go any deeper.
come to end on the earth.
When you listen to yourself praying, you listen to your prayer requests.
About 70% of your prayer requests, they are what?
Men of old, they cried in those days, they said, give me children or I die. And they're asking for spiritual children.
Someone knelt down and said, God, give me Scotland or I die.
Let me tell you something. It is not that their prayer was more than our prayer.
There is no value of my vigils in our generation that it has ever been anywhere else.
But you see, it is not affecting the land. Why?
Because it is of war, the earth.
Because the enemy has made a strategy to fill up with earth those who have us. And we are asked, you see God, so make this valley full of ditches. You won't see them, you won't see them. That's not the issue. But don't you understand me? Even if it erodes into a world that has been filled with the earth, how much water can you contain? And whatever water you contain, is it drinkable water? What is it? It only made that place to become a marsh. And God is demanding tonight. Sincerely, it needs strength for God to be saying, make this valley full of ditches. And God is saying to me, speak these people, speak them. Put the earth from their hands. So that the land might be filled with water. I don't know what I'm going to say. God is saying, look, these lines, they are filled. They have been blocked. With what? With earth. With earth. They cannot allow the fresh water that will bring revival to the whole land to flow. They are filled already. Scoop them. Scoop them. Scoop them. And feed them to say, look, revival is already there. But the trouble that these ones, they are filled with what? With the earth. These brothers you are presenting before me, they are filled with the earth. Their taste must be changed. They must be evacuated. The problem is not where shall we get water. God says we will have water. Hallelujah. God said, we don't even need to feel wind before water flows. But this valley has to be scooped. It has to be evacuated. The Philistines, very wise in their plans. Maybe the biggest thing that the Philistines are doing to the church of today, is that we have stopped our labor with us. Our faith has been blocked with the earth. Even as we are talking about revival here, if God wants to expose your heart, you will discover that you don't understand what you are talking about. Some of you are saying, let down the revival, let the revival come, and we will not be there. Let us pray now. You will see the kind of thing that is jumping out of your heart, which you are praying about the earth. You will see God coming with a very strange instruction. Make these bodies. These are containers of body that are blocked. And if you are going to pray with me tonight, if God will have mercy on us, every earthly thing. You know, some of you have received terribly anointing and confess souls. But what have you received that anointing for? The earth. The earth. If you see the volume of demons you are casting out from your business, even David's muddy water is not good for drinking, yet they are still using it that leads to water power. Some of the main things that some of you are having today, they are muddy. You can no longer perform the highest purposes of God. But it is useful because it is servicing some certain little things. We are at different levels of blockage. Anyway, there are some people that what you can get out of their lives now is solid earth. Whether you understand what I mean by solid earth. When there is water and you pour plenty sand, plenty laterite, what does it become? It becomes a lump. That's the level for some. For some others, if as you don't bring them to that extent, you could still get something that looks like water, but very pink. But even that one, if you carry it for one for a long time, it will settle. You will see the sediment of the earth. But the problem is that anytime you want to put your cup to fetch the water, what happens? The sediment jumps up again. So whosoever is drinking from that kind of water will drink fine with it.
Unfortunately,
together by the light of the world, and they kept the sand. And if we know this, that's normally what happens to us. We put your tea. Then the Philistines came back. What are you doing here? That time they needed no shovel. Where are they?
the anointing goes forth at Antioch under Barnabas, the leader, there was nothing in the past that he was pursuing back in Jerusalem. I heard the Holy Spirit say, something strange to me tonight that it will not be yet after you. Those of you that are shouting, oh God, those of you that are shouting, that's what happened. But to me, the Philistines, Holy Spirit in them be active, and the Holy Spirit in us could also be. I feel better. No. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. Make this vow.
What?
What is your activity? Scoop out the earth. They receive it in the form of your body.
You receive this man in the other way.
And you see that the water is the earth. When you begin to love. The book is so many. Moving for you. There's no problem. Blocked.
When I blow with sin, the majority of you don't give the earth.
The sun there is well as spinning water. And you have now a good and deep spring with all you guys may see. The water is ours. And as you are saying, this is the best. If you don't want water, this is truly want to help us tonight. And let people reach out for your digger. Let people start digging with your technology. What is it that has rendered the praying God the mighty? This is more difficult because it is underneath the surface. Hallelujah. This is much more difficult because I'm asking you to dig out what is inside. If it is not on the surface, you can quickly pick it and soup. We are not talking of soup tonight. And I'm talking about the day. But if you kneel down with God, the presence of God, what the truth is that has made your grace in my life so mighty and mighty that it is not affecting anybody. Listen to me before you pray with me tonight. One thing. And that Philip was not the Philip among the apostles. Philip, the one you now call the evangelist, the one that was appointed a deacon, the one who was going to Samaria. And what did the Bible report about this? It's what in Samaria. What did the Bible report? That Samaria, the whole of Samaria, were brought to the earth in revival because Philip went and preached Jesus. That Philip was not preaching in the environment. What was he doing? He was shining there. What did God give Philip? What else did Philip have? What has made the Holy Spirit that we have received for years to be so negative? The earth. Now the darkness of the earth is ethnic. The speaks of the earth. It means the things of the earth. It pursues the things of the earth. Thank you. Jesus is relying on this time. That's why he was speaking. It was such things that are loaded up who could have said this time. what goes down is whatever God is giving to us. Why has this our own value paddle up? Why is he only just a maximum? Shadows of us. They did it gradually. Do not just pray generally. I want you to ask God. What has filled your imagination?
God has reduced your usefulness in the hand of God.
Gracias.